And welcome back. Previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm, we saw them doing that, and Rachel's gotta have some sort of ability. And this guy's had it out for us. This is where David's like, some juicy things came out. We did some shady stuff, also ending up helping them at the end of the day, I'm hoping. The fire is still burning. And we became a bird. We were a pretty badass bird. Yeah, Rachel snapped at her dad, and then some juicy bits came out. Turns out the woman we saw him locking lips with was her mom and not her mom, but it is her mom. This is confusing. So that kind of puts a dent in our plans to run away tonight.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Of course.
I see the way you look at Chloe, man.
In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah. Your... birth mother. I'm going to tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Chloe. I'm right here. Good. I need you.
In high school, there was one person everyone adored. Her teachers, her friends. Sarah was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it when she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long.
She was so beautiful, just like you.
She was so alive, so passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. While the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families, Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape. Sarah became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father was the greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind. However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough. For Sarah, the need to escape was always there. For over a year, I tried to help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. Was wrong. Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. A destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied by anyone or anything, even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again. What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel, it was true. We kissed. It was the saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her, and I was happy for her, that she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done, but after all the people she hurt. All the lives she destroyed. I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world. The chance to be your mother. And she squandered it. It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again. And again. And again, to keep you safe.
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. It's our arrangement.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
You think you have the right to decide that for her?
When I left Sarah, when I took Rachel away, I truly believe I saved her life. And I will continue to protect her no matter what.
But maybe she's different now. I mean, people change, right?
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to
you.
That
is true.
Rachel. I think I need to lie down.
Rachel and Chloe, where are you guys? We're at the Tempest Claw's party. I already texted Rachel like 8 times. I don't think we're making it. You should come. Yeah, Chloe, you did awesome. Hey, Chloe, great job tonight. Thanks, I can't. But you were amazing. I'll even admit that Mr. Keaton seemed a little disappointed when I arrived. Seriously, just come. Bring Rachel. Sorry, guys.
I can't leave Rachel to deal with this alone.
There we go. Up. Let's see if we can talk. It's a big bomb. Just casually, like, there you go. Catch it with your hands. Do-si-do. Her room is kind of sweet. That's kind of cool.
Rachel? Some way to show Rachel that I'm here for her. Hey, Rachel. I'm glad you're here, Chloe. Of course. I know something Miss Arcadia doesn't. Weird.
Is the real... If that... Oh, it's the fire.
Rachel's always made being an A student seem so... I think Rachel could use another subject. But which one? That's the one. Rachel's really into stars. I wonder if it's her way of feeling connected. Even you, Willie, couldn't come up with the tragedy Rachel's going through. At least she'll have something from tonight. I've heard that Rachel and Nathan hang out sometimes, but it still seems hard to believe. Hey. I bet Rachel would rather be anywhere but here. Maybe I can make the world a less scary place. On stage, I think Rachel said... We were so close to making our break last night. Now...
Leaving the door unlocked in case you don't have your key. Please come home. Doesn't matter if it's after curfew. Mom, I can't right now, please. Yeah. Good talk to David.
This light needs more light. Wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that nightlight. Rachel's surrounded by so much love, yet she seems so... for Rachel's light show. Better get her attention first. Hey, check it out.
It's beautiful.
I thought you might like it.
I've always loved stars.
Why?
They remind us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see.
Because we're blinded by what's in front of us.
Exactly. But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years. They're all lies.
But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right?
I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point? It's all lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore. And that other woman, my real mom, she's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust.
I'll take it. Even if it's only by process of elimination.
Good. I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone.
You should take it back.
No. There's nowhere else I'd rather keep it than me. The fact that she's here right now, that she came here for me. I think I need to see her. Is that wrong?
Of course not. But it might be tough to track her down.
Yeah. That's true. Luckily, I've got my secret weapon.
We can ask Frank.
But what if we can't find her? It's not like I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start.
I think I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You'd do that?
I'll give it a shot.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her.
We'll fix the car.
I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
Don't worry. I've got that one covered too.
You do?
Yep. In fact, anything you could come up with, I'll handle it.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I didn't know how to keep talking to him. I still don't. But it doesn't matter. All that matters is that he's there.
Hey, they're very creepy in your dreams,
your
woman.
In my dreams, he's there.
It's like old Scarface and stuff.
And it's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right.
We're in another weird dream. It's like a play. Sorry guys, just getting my cat some water. We're a bird again! And David's there. Oh, lovely.
Dad, I think we're stuck. Hey, maybe you should let me drive. You always do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go? Remember when we used to work on cars together? Those are some of my favorite memories.
Don't you mean my memories? I don't think you remember after you're dead.
Touché. All right, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
Thank you.
What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
Fine. It's... the spark plug.
No, that's not it. I just had that replaced.
Isn't improv supposed to be all about yes and?
Yes and what?
Dad, stop. None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
I don't know.
Something about the whole world being a stage. So, might as well act the fuck out of it.
Nailed it.
But I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself. Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Dad?
Relax, sweetie. It's all pretend, right?
Right.
Just a bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me. Look at me, sweetheart. It's going to be okay.
Yo! Why she just keeps reliving that?
Boo!
Ach, Victoria. And that is all we have time for in today's episode, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!